Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive audio interview. Today is the 24th of November 2010, and I'm talking with Jeremy Metcalfe, Communications Director of Strategic Natural Resources, listed on the AIM market, mining sector, stock ticker SNRP, share price 15 pence, market cap 15.59 million pounds sterling, web address snrplc.co.uk. Jeremy, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
Yes, I'm looking forward to it, Harry.
Please give investors a brief introduction to Strategic Natural Resources and tell us how confident we can be that the company's coal assets in the Eastern Cape coalfields of South Africa are world-class.
The company went on the London Stock Exchange on AIM in August 2007 with an objective of finding a great deal of coal. And in the intervening period, we have drilled an awful lot of holes, and we have found a tremendous amount of coal, yet we've only drilled something like 3% of the total area that we have under our control. Fairly early on, we raised our game from a mere 50 million tonnes. We now stand at about 155 million tonnes. And by extrapolation, it shows that we could be looking at something in the order of 3 billion tonnes of coal. Now, clearly, we're not going to get all of that out of the ground, but we may well get a billion tonnes of coal out of the ground in the future. And I would say that anyone with a 1 billion extractable coal asset has to have a world-class asset in their hands. And I think this is how we're going to turn out to be.
On July the 21st, a resource update was announced for Elethani coal, which is also the first phase of a bankable export feasibility study. Please talk us through this resource update and what it means for Strategic Natural Resources.
As I said in my earlier answer, we now have about 150 million tonnes of coal. Now, of that 150 million tonnes, at least 30 million tonnes is considered entirely the right type of coal for export. And so from that point of view, it gives us considerable confidence that the export feasibility study that has been completed does show that we will be able to sell our coal overseas.
What are the local markets for Elethani's coal, and how accessible are these markets, Jeremy?
Well, a number of markets come to light. Clearly, the biggest market, of course, is to provide coal to independent power companies so that they can make electricity. South Africa is extremely short of electricity and will remain short over the coming year. So that is clearly a very big market for us. We've also identified a number of industrial users who, not being confident that they can always have access to electricity, have established their own burners and boilers to convert coal into electricity and heat and power. These are targets of ours, and we will be supplying a number of those businesses over the coming years with considerable quantities of our coal. And we joined forces with one of the largest boiler makers in the world, Thermax, and we will be announcing some fairly major contract details fairly soon.
On the 30th of September, the logistics study on the transporting of coal from Elethani coal mine to the port infrastructure in the Eastern Cape was published, which is the second phase of Elethani coal's export feasibility study. What did this study conclude, Jeremy?
Well, in order to export, you've got to know that you've got a mining plan that works. And the mining plan is a very, very complicated business plan involving a huge number of calculations, a huge number of safety factors. We have to be absolutely certain that we can get the coal out of the ground at an economic price so that it is then possible to put it on wagons and ship it down to East London, where it will eventually be put onto ships and eventually to the ultimate end user, mainly probably countries like India, South Korea, and to some extent China.
What are the conclusions of the third and final phase of the Elethani coal export feasibility study, which focused on washability and market applications, and what conclusions do you draw from this study?
Professor Falcon, who is a renowned coal expert, has given her conclusions, and we're very pleased to note that our coal quite clearly is not only exportable, but it has high metallurgical properties. In other words, it can be used very successfully in the smelting process as a reductant. It is suitable for export to countries like Turkey, where they use this type of coal for heating purposes. And of course, it is entirely suitable for burning in fluidized bed boilers. These are the beasts that create massive electricity. So, yeah, lots of good uses.
What are Strategic Natural Resources' Black Empowerment arrangements, Jeremy?
Well, we have just concluded a phenomenally interesting and very, very good deal with Mr. Stone Cizani and his company. Now, under South African law, every mining company has to have a black empowerment partner. They have to have in total 26% of the share capital. Mr. Stone Cizani, he is currently a member of parliament in the South African government. He's a highly respected man. He spent time on Robben Island at the same time as Mr. Nelson Mandela. And what's more, his organization has put money into our company. Not only have we got a man who is highly respected, but he's made a very substantial investment. Now, there aren't many small AIM companies that can boast such a good result.
What is Strategic Natural Resources cash burn, and what is the company's financial situation going forward, Jeremy?
Well, we are fairly economic with the money we spend, and it's running at about £100,000 per month. I suppose if you break that down, 80% of that is expended in South Africa and 20% here in the United Kingdom. We have a good runway, probably just over a year at the moment, on the existing money that we have in the Treasury. As the back empowerment cash comes in, then of course that will increase our runway considerably. Cash is not a problem at the moment, although eventually we will need to raise further money, but mostly by way of a bankable feasibility study, i.e. we'll raise money through bank debt. But at the moment we are well funded and we're going forward as fast as we possibly can.
What can investors expect from Strategic Natural Resources over the next 12 to 18 months?
Well, I suppose the one thing that most people are looking for, and indeed we are keen to get out, if you like, are offtake agreements. Offtake agreements of a substantial nature for our coal. For example, into a power station, an offtake agreement, something in the region of 2 million tonnes of coal a year. For export, offtake agreements ranging from 500,000 tonnes, rising to 2.5 million tonnes per year. Offtake agreements to supply large factories using commercial boilers, using our coal, anything from 400 to 500, maybe 5,000 tonnes of coal per month for some of them, and offtake agreements to supply the domestic market generally. So there'll be a lot of announcements coming out. At the moment, I think it's fair to say that our company is very undervalued for what we have, and I suspect that as these announcements are made, people will begin to realise that Strategic Natural Resources really is a company to be reckoned with.
Who are Strategic Natural Resources' major shareholders, and how are your relationships with them?
Our major shareholder, I suppose at the moment, is Coal of Africa, and it's very good to have a good commercial coal operator as a shareholder with us. We work together on a number of fronts. The next biggest shareholders, of course, are the family of Nell, Barry Nell and his son David, through their company Cape Corridor. They've got about 15%, and then really the rest of the shareholders that aren't directors are held by a lot of nominee companies. It is sometimes quite difficult to know who they are, but I think most of them are there, I hope they are, for the long term.
Do you anticipate any mine reclamation issues or community issues at Elisenie, Jeremy?
None at all is the short answer to that. We are very well supported by the local community. The local community, I'd like to point out, they've got a huge unemployment level. It's 98.9%, some absolutely huge level of unemployment. So by bringing this mine into life and by employing maybe 1,000, 2,000 people, those 2,000 people will generate something like 15,000 other jobs in the local area. So the support we're getting from the municipality is absolutely terrific. And being an adit mine, i.e. we go in at the side of the mountain and extract the coal straight out onto conveyors and then either into lorries or into the power station or into rail trucks, there's very little reclamation it will be required. Bear in mind, this mine will be active probably for the next 50 to 100 years. It's a big mine, and it's going to provide a huge number of benefits for the local people.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.